We are going to create 5 different maps in Tableau and learn how to create set, edit location, map layers, dual access and custom symbol features. Let's get started. This is the data that we will be using to create maps. Link to this data is available in the description. Province and territory sheet to create filled map, also called as choropleth map. City sheet to create point distribution, proportional symbol and heat map. The third sheet is via rail, that's to create a route map. Now let's open the Excel file. Drag tables to combine them using relationship method. We have already covered combining tables in a separate video. You can check it out. Now open a new worksheet and name it as province. The globe symbol beside the province field indicates that Tableau has automatically categorized the field as geographical data. We can also change the category if needed. Double-click the province field and select the map option from the drop-down list in the mark shelf. That's all required to create a filled map. It's easy, yeah? Drag the population density per square kilometer field to the color mark to color code the map. Dark color indicates densely populated areas. Drag province and population fields to the labels mark to add labels to the map. Let's format the labels. Select allow labels to overlap to display all names. Let's abbreviate the numbers to make it easy to read. Finally, let us reposition the labels to avoid overlapping. Filled map is ready now. It's also called as choropleth map. It's a Greek word. Let's see quickly how to create sets before proceeding to the next map. Select territories. Click create set symbol and name the set as territories. Then the set can be used to filter the data. Easy, right? Let's create the point distribution map now. Open new worksheet, city. Double click cities to create a point distribution map. It shows two unknowns. Click it and click edit locations. Victoria and Windsor are reported as ambiguous data. We are going to add the latitude and longitude information to fix them. It's easy to copy the latitude and longitude information from Google Map by right clicking at the location of interest. Let's fill the data for both Victoria and Windsor. It's all set now. Now let's see how to create proportional symbol map. Drag the population field to the size mark. We can see the size of the symbol is proportional to the population. The size can be increased to make the differences obvious. The map is ready. If you notice, there are several cities overlapping in the southern Ontario. This is where the heat map helps. Select density from the drop-down list. Change the color palette. Increase the intensity slightly. Ta-da! The heat map is ready. Now let's customize using map layers. Click the map menu and click map layers. There are several styles available to select, including the street view. Let's select the dark style option for this map. The layers can be customized as required. For this map, let's keep only the country border layer. The heat map is ready. The next one is the route map. Before proceeding, let's look at the data once again. The route ID column and the route order column are important to create a route map. We have train and flight routes defined in the table. We have also added latitude and longitude information in the table. Let's go back to the Tableau and open a new sheet. Drag latitude to the row shelf and longitude to the column shelf. Drag route ID to the details mark. Drop down the list and select the line option. drag the root field to the path mark and change it to dimension. The route map is ready now. One way from Toronto by train and return by flight from Vancouver. Let's add a filter to focus on the train route only. We are going to use a dual axis and custom shape features in the Tableau to customize it. Drag latitude again to the row shelf. We can see two maps and three mark shelf. The selection in the first mark shelf covers both maps. The second one covers the upper map and the third one covers the lower map. Let's create the third mark shelf. Change the options to shapes. Click more shapes. In the drop-down list, we see the available standard shape. But for this map, we need a train symbol to make it more fancy. It's easy to add it in Tableau. All we have to do is copy the custom symbol folder and paste them in the Tableau repository under the shapes folder. Let's go back to Tableau. Click reload shapes. Now we can select the train symbol. Select it. Increase the size a little bit. Drag city and departure details to the label field. Change the departure time to minute option. Select allow labels to overlap so all labels are visible. Now let's combine the two maps by selecting the dual axis option. Now the route map is ready. Let's relocate the labels to make it easier to read. Open map layers and drag washout to 100% to hide the background map. This shows just the route. Ooh, interesting. Thank you. Create a map. Board a train. Enjoy the journey. Learning is fun.